gonna be working on some extra stuff here to get the sigils, whatever it is, for the ultimate weapons. We already have all the ultimate weapons. I'm pretty sure I have the crests. Now we need to find all of the sigils to totally upgrade them. Every time we hit a red butterfly, it shaves a couple seconds off of our time, and we really need those. Or what I've decided I like to do is just run the time out and just go for a clean run. As you can see, it's a lot more time consuming to keep running through once you've lost a couple seconds, because every red butterfly that you hit is not only a time subtraction, but it's a random encounter. If you keep going with this, you're going to see a lot of the toggling on and off of the turbo. Speeds things up a little bit, but we can't use it for the butterfly catching because it speeds the timer up too. I think the hardest part about this is that your depth perception gets really screwed up by the camera angles. Woohoo! It's no good for anybody. Characters for a couple rounds here, just so we could spread the XP that we get. Not like really working for it, Oh, that was bad. Come on now. Okay, it was a little farther that time. It's really hard to get the patterns down, because the depth perception is so off due to the camera angles. Too time consuming, just not to have everybody shred through these guys. Yeah, this is where it's a little bit out of control. So now we wait. Time out again. Thank you. was too short.
Wow, okay. I think I'm understanding now. Get the treasure. Did I get it? Nope, there it is. Alright, that was cool. There's one more area to do.
Do it! Thank you.
Everybody's already done. Yeah. Okay. No, I'm not doing the butterflies. I guess the game thinks it's funny to try it again, but not interested. Well, here goes.
This'll be easy!
No time to waste. Let's go. No time to waste. Let's go.
We're getting further with it. Let's just keep on with it.
Victory for now.
I don't know what it wants me to do. Maybe I need to cling the wall better? I don't really know. It's close though. It's getting close. Doesn't feel as bad as the other one. My first one was pretty tough. That took a long time to get the hang of. Okay, now what am I supposed to do? Okay, hesitated a little bit, but I see now.
No time to waste. Let's go.
It happened. Fantastic. That's beautiful. we're gonna be sure to save for this one. We're gonna take a break for a couple minutes and we'll be back shortly. What we'll do next, maybe we'll try the Chocobo games.
The final showdown. Get used to this song. Good looking time. Yeah, ouch. There's no way deductions are gonna come even close. Ooh. Oh, not good. Thank you.
Might as well just keep at it. Avoid the birds, first and foremost.
balloons, they help a lot, but I need to get around the birds. That's basically where I'm losing it, everything, is getting the bird hits. Closer. We'll be right back. Oh, hey, dude. Good to have you here. Yeah, this is the stage where we're at now. Good to have you here. Thanks for bearing with madness. At least I have some hope for this mini game. I haven't even tried the lightning dodging yet for Lulu's upgrade. I am absolutely not looking forward to that at all. I can't even hit the lightning dodge once, let alone that many times. I mean, even plugging in the enemy encounters off, it's not gonna be a good time. See what you're saying. Unfortunately, the turbo function doesn't really work on this either. We just did the butterfly catching, and you can't play that with the turbo on, that's too insane, but it would be nice to speed this up a little bit. Glad we're on the same page with that one. Yeah, that was painful. That was painful. Yeah, that's one of those one and done things you don't really ever want to do in a game. I haven't even started the Cactuar quest yet. Or really the monster arena. I mean, I've been catching monsters, but I haven't even messed around with the monster arena yet. I mean, speaking of this area of the map. To like a mini game, because that's what most of these are. It's like, oh hey, here's this mini game. By the way, you're gonna really need it later on in the game if you want your ultimate weapons. Good luck. Doesn't sound so bad. Sounds kind of fun, actually. I guess we'll do this a little longer, then I think we'll have to end on a good note. Maybe do some Blitzball. Well, honestly, for the Blitz, I'm just playing it for a Waka's weapon upgrade and his real upgrades, because I have not played at all in the game up until this point. But there are a lot of really good Blitz guides out there. No, RNG's not being very kind to me. Alright. We can come back to this at any time. And I really don't actually mind this too much. Yes, please. Thank you. Alright, where are we at? Super Turbo is where we're at. Let's see if we have any goodies waiting us here. No, I'm not trying to fight right now. Thanks, guy. We saved. Uh-oh. I'm a little scared of B-Saved. I'm not going to be saved right now, buddy. There's a big nasty waiting for me, and I don't want to fight him right now. Alright, let's get this going. Oh, can't tournament for right now, so I guess we have to do qualifying or whatever this counts as for tournaments. I don't know. Give me Wedge. Brother, why did I have this guy again? What was he playing? He wasn't guard. Mew was guard. Why did I have this guy? Yo, I feel for you. My heart goes out to you for that one. 199 out of 200 and then boom. That's devastating. I'm sorry to hear that.
Tidus. Tidus, Brother, Wedge, Veroja, and Mew, and Zebronzo. Right now, I don't think I have Zeb in. Gosh, everybody's just circling like a bunch of goofies. Dang, let's go back to normal here. The center thing isn't working for the time being. Really waiting for to free up is actually Nimrook. I think he's out bed. I'm waiting for him to free up so he can be gold, because his stats are pretty mean. Mio's good for the time being. I mean, definitely way better than Keepa. It. I don't know if I'll be making any more changes. Thank you for the heads up there. Yeah, I guess I really didn't know about them at all. I'm just doing Blitz by guides. I'm not really doing, not really figuring it out for myself. I'm just trying to look up, okay, there's a team. Tidus, Wedge, Brother, Rop, Uroja, Mew, Zebronzo, and Zalots. Why do I even have Zalots again? I don't know. Whatever. Brother catches it. Oh, come on. Ooh. Okay. I don't know what the goalie ability is called, but it's basically the equivalent of Sphere Shot that they have there. Let's try this again, buddy. Interesting. That's a little bit of lore that I never knew about. That's good to know, though. My Blitz level isn't terribly high. I might be able to go back and get him. That's cool. It's good to know. Just finished Zanarkand and Unaleska, and then just kind of bailed with the airship and took full advantage of the airship from that time. Did go to the Omega Ruins once, and the only reason we did that was to get the Last Outbed Primer. That was not fun. That was not a fun place. Yeah, it wasn't a fun place. Went to the Omega Ruins. That Last Outbid Primer. But no, we didn't beat Sin yet. Throw a monster catching inside Sin. Also what we've been working on, just as our regular weapons. Just catch everything all the time. Oh, that wasn't a good choice. Wedge's pass is crap. Thank you.
Go you, dude.
I don't think I finished anything inside Sin. I just got to the Lady Unaleska fight, and immediately when we got the airship after that, just started to just do side quests and pick up items, all that fun stuff. That's all we've been up to. Just a lot of side questing right now. Expired. Lackham signed a contract. Guado Glorious. Guado. Paul's not a bad player. I don't really want that guy. Chido. No. Please come back. Brother. Sure, why not? Oh. Okay, cool. Yeah, I'll take it. Let's blitz. Oh, I don't mind leveling up and smashing on bosses. I want to try to do the super bosses after I get all the weapons and possibly some armor from the monster arena. That's the plan. We'll see what actually happens. I don't know if I'll get bored. Well, that's the plan. We'll see how it actually pans out. It's a lot easier said than done.
Here we go, put the jack shot on your head. Oh, thank you for the strat. It's a good idea. Yeah, that's part of the reason I want to get the Celestial Weapon, because right now, I've been to the Omega Ruins once and I got pretty rocked. I only went for the Albed Primer, but jeez, those random encounters were fierce. Especially the Malboros that have initiative equipped on them. That was harsh. Absolutely no fun there. At all. Just made sure I had my finger on that flea button. That was the only way it even worked. I got lucky with Malboro because some characters with flea snapped out of whatever status effects they have. So I have flea on Tidus and Kamari. So, having those two in at the same time, at least you have two-thirds of a chance of having a character with flea. And RNG will tell the rest. Have Dispel and Isuna on here. What I've been doing for most of the game is just rotating characters in for the sake of having them in, even if it's to do something stupid like use an item or, in Riku's case, Steel. I think I have Steel on Riku, Kamari, and Yuna. Kamar is just kind of an auxiliary character, so he kind of went everywhere. He's currently on Aran's sphere grid, learning breaks, but... yeah, I did a lot of character swapping, plus, you know, Turbo helps a lot. The times 2 and the times 4 Turbo definitely does something. Just isn't right. Up with your character, you know, make sure you don't miss out on any AP. I've been doing it more recently just because almost everybody's at the end of their speed grid, so they're gonna start crossing over and they're gonna start using level 3 and 4 spears left and right, so that's why I haven't really been doing a lot of spear grid upgrading, because I'm at the end. Oh, did take the choke on one level 4 and ended up unlocking Lulu's dual cast, so that's a good thing. Oh, good to know. Thank you. Level 4 and level 3 spheres. Awesome. Thank you very much for that. See that coming. All right, that's game. Cool. That's really good to know because I haven't really looked up any gil farming techniques. Gil was pretty easy in 7 and 8 when I just played through them recently. 9, I don't remember. I played that a couple years ago last time. But I played 7 and 8 within the past year, and Gil wasn't really an issue there. 8 was easy once you got a good system down, but I'm glad you gave me a tip for the Gil in this. You really know your stuff here. I'm glad for the input, honestly, considering I haven't played this game. I haven't played this game since I was a teenager in the 2000s, so. Okay, we're gonna save here. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully we'll see you next time. Do have a good night. Wow, that's expensive armor. Hey, you too, take care. And thanks again for watching. Peace out, man.